Okay, so today we have the Undertones and Teenage Kicks. Now, the Undertones were requested, and also somebody left in their comment that this song was really important to John Peel, who I know was an influential DJ, very well, renowned and everything. And this was, I guess, one of, if not his favorite song. So, that's intriguing right off the bat. So, yeah, the Undertones, I've never heard of this band. This will be my first listen to them. So, let's get into it, talk about it after. I'm going to try to watch the video. Hopefully, it doesn't get blocked. So yeah, let's go. Smiley drummer.
She was mad, she looks so good. I wanna hold her tight. Get teenage kicks right through the night. I'm gonna call her on the telephone. Have her over cause I'm all alone. I need excitement, oh I need it bad. And it's the best I've ever had. I wanna hold her tight. Get teenage kicks right through.
I mean, holy moly. So the Undertones and Teenage Kicks. Okay, so like I said, my first listen to the band, coming in here, knowing that they were kind of, I guess, a Northern Irish, I guess you would say kind of punk band, but almost like a pop punk sound as well, power pop as well in there. Anyway, and just I just love the name of the lead singer here, Feargal Sharkey. Now that name will catch you. And I mean, just to talk about the music, and I guess the music video right off the top. I mean, he's a captivating looking guy, almost like a unibrow, I guess. All of the eyebrows going on there, I guess I have to say. And just I mean, yeah, the red pants, I mean, they catch you. I don't know, I like the aesthetic of the whole band, and as well as I said right off the top, the drummer, very smiley, very happy looking. I don't know if he was really happy, if he it was just for the video, if he was, as they say, taking the piss. And yeah, and anyway, and yeah, he just looked very happy, very smiley, and just I don't know, that that caught my attention right off the bat. I just like that, how they just panned to him and he's just smiling away. But yeah, and then also I like, just I don't know, like I said, just the way the guys look. They all look like they're having fun. I mean, Feargal himself seems very energetic. His voice, I mean, goddamn, it's almost androgynous in a way. It's almost like it's a very, like, it's a high, I guess you would say, a tenor, and it's very, kind of shaky in a way. And like I said, during the song, when he would say, like, the best I ever had, like the way he pronounced had and the way he pronounced bad, I need you bad. It's just, I don't know, his pronunciations, whatever the fuck. It was very different to me. Nothing like I've heard before. His voice, very high. I'd like to just hear a speaking voice, honestly, just just to see what he sounds like normally, I guess. But when he sings here, yeah, he sounds very kind of high. Almost reminds me, and it is in my recommended next to the videos here, the Buzzcocks. Almost reminds me of, you know, Pete Shelley in a way, kind of, I guess, a higher voice in the punk realm, I guess you would say. So that came to mind as well with the Buzzcocks and, yeah, Pete Shelley. But again, he does have a different sound, doesn't exactly sound like him, just kind of gave me those vibes, you know what I mean? Anyway, so yeah, I just really enjoyed everything going on here. and also, I have to say, again, they look like they're having so much fun. They look like, you know, they don't look like rock. I guess they kind of look like rock stars in a way, but they're looking like, you know, working class boys. I mean, they're looking like they're just having fun, like I said, and they're just, you know, there for the video, you know, nothing really, I don't know, they just look like normal everyday people. I mean, that's what I really liked about it too. And as well, I just like, you know, kind of, I guess there's the backing vocalists on it. I like the little guitar solo in there. I'm glad they fit in a guitar solo, you know, in a 2.5 minute song. And actually, I do want to see the personnel here because I don't know everybody. So yes, Feargal Sharkey, and I just love that name. It almost sounds like a stage name, but Feargal is his real middle name, and his last name is Sharkey. So, I mean, I just love that he used Feargal instead of his real first name, I guess, which is Sean. So, I mean, Sean Sharkey, that'd be cool, too. Sean Sharkey, there you go. Anyway, on lead vocals here, of course, John O'Neill on rhythm guitar, Damien O'Neill on lead guitar. So I'm thinking Damien, because the boy in blue, in the video anyway, the boy in blue, when he was like singing along, and you know, he was singing into a mic at some points, but there was one point where he was just singing and wasn't into a mic. And it's just, this was another point there where it just seemed like to me where they were just like, hell yeah, we're making a record here. We're making a video. And just, I don't know, they look like they were having fun. I just keep coming back to that. Anyway, so yeah, Damien on lead guitar here. And backing vocals, as well as John Ann on bass guitar here with Mickey Bradley, who was also on backing vocals. And apparently he was on lead vocals for one of the songs on the album. Again, this is for the Undertones album personnel. Anyway, and then Billy Doherty. I want to say Doherty. Doherty. Anyway, I always see the last name. I've seen him before. I know there's Denny Doherty, I want to say again, for the Mamas and the Papas. But anyway, Billy here on drums. And like I said, he caught my attention right off the bat. I loved his drumming as well. And how, I guess he didn't really start off the song because, you know, there's guitars and the drums, how it started off, but he had a great rhythm. Really enjoyed, and you know, come back to the, you know, the music, the instruments, just a great guitar hook as well. I mean, everything here was just very, it was very spicy. It was very, I mean, it just, the musicianship was again, great, for these young guys. And yeah, I just, you know, it was such a great, powerful kind of song. And again, all about, you know, I guess that teenage angst, I mean, teenage kicks, I mean, you're gonna probably think, you know, again, how young these guys were, you're gonna think it's about, you know, teenage things, whatever, but yeah, teenage angst all over the place here. Just a brilliant track, and again, the relatability for, because again, I didn't look at the lyrics when I was watching the video, but I heard some stuff that he was saying, but yeah, so it's just like a, you know, a teenage kind of brilliance song, brilliant teenage song, there you go. Anyway, good lord. So I'm just getting into lyrics here just because I want to see some stuff here. The first line just grabs you. A teenage dream's so hard to beat. And I mean, that's just such a truthful statement, especially just on my mind. I mean, I guess I'm a few years removed from being a teenager, now being 24, God sakes. Anyway, a teenage dream so hard to beat, because when you're a teenager, I mean, you have all these dreams. I mean, that's when you're trying to figure out what do you want to do with your life, you know, coming out of high school, going into university or college, whatever you want to do, or just, you know, going somewhere else, whatever the hell, but trying to figure out what you want to do with your life. And again, it's very you know, hard situation. At that point, you seem like, you know, the world's your oyster in a way, but also you're scared as hell. Anyway, so yeah, just like a teenage dream is so hard to beat. It's just like, because again, you're so full of youth and your energy, usually anyway, and it's just like, you know, when you have a dream at that point, it's just, it is hard to beat. So it's just such a great line to open with. I mean, holy shit. Anyway, every time she walks down the street, another girl in the neighborhood, wish she was mine, she looks so good. And again, I guess longing for this girl here. And again, just very, I mean, especially when you're a teenager, your hormones are going crazy. I can attest to that. Anyway, chorus, I want to hold her tight, get teenage kicks through the night, right through the night. And I guess, you know, again, without looking at anything here, on the screen or whatever, you know, on the research, I would imagine that, you know, there is some sex, you know, thoughts of sex, I guess. And there is actually an annotation here on the chorus. Let me just see. And again, because, you know, I want to hold her tight. I mean, yeah, that kind of thing. You know, hold her tight through the night. Get teenage kicks right through the night. It does say here, this line is in the song is about sex. So, yeah, he wants to hold her tight and he get teenage kicks right through the night, implying he wants to have sex with this girl. Now, again, this annotation from this person might be wrong. I don't know. But there does seem, because, again, when you're a teenager, I mean, like I said, those thoughts do come to your mind. Anyway, second verse, I'm going to call her on the telephone, like the specific here. Specific thing of being on the telephone. Have her over because I'm all alone. I need excitement. Oh, I need it bad. And again, I love how we pronounce that. And it's the best I've ever had. And yeah. And then the chorus, once again, I want to hold her tight. And then, all right. I just love, you know, the enthusiasm again. It's so good. And again, with Feargal on the vocals here and how he's delivering these words and what he looks like and what his voice sounds like, it's all just a perfect combination. And then I like that they just start the song over. They go right back to the first verse, chorus, second verse, basically to lengthen it, I guess. And I like that the song's only 2.5 minutes. So it's like if they just had that first part without, you know, going over it again, that would have been an even shorter song. So I just like that they said, well, hell with it. Let's just redo it all again, because why the hell not? And it really fit as well. I didn't really notice that they just went right back to the start and started over. But yeah, because again, I was just, in trance with the video and I guess all that stuff. Anyway, one thing that I come back to here is John Peel, I want to say, before, because this video is over, I guess I'm almost done anyway. but yeah, with John Peel, I just want to say again, apparently this song was his favorite. And I'm looking here on songfacts.com. And I feel like, you know, I just want to read this part just because, again, because I don't know how much it meant to John Peel. So I just want to read this part for me, I guess. And if you want to hear it as well, why not? This song got them a record deal when British DJ John Peel played it on his show. Peel was a very influential and well-respected DJ, and he raved about this, even playing the song twice in a row, something he never did before. So obviously this song really touched him. I mean, my God, with Peel's endorsement, it became a punk anthem and got the group signed to Sire Records. So John Peel was obviously a big part in this. And as Sharky says here, he said, our only hope was John Peel, and we sent him a copy. That was the only copy we sent anyone. And it was the only copy they had to send. Holy shit. And it says Peel died on October 25th, 2004. The song was played at his funeral. So obviously, and even here, it also says the first line of the song is on his gravestone. Which I already said, which I can't even remember what the first line of the song was. A teenage dream so hard to beat, isn't it? Yes, or scrolling up. A teenage dream so hard to beat, which is on his gravestone. So obviously this really touched him. And apparently as well, just looking through Song Facts again, apparently it made him burst out in tears when he first heard that line. So obviously, I mean, there are those songs that just get different people. I mean, there's those songs for me that, you know, I don't know if the songs made me cry. Honestly, I mean, just as an aside, I guess the last song I think that made me cry when I was in my feels was, All Mixed Up by the Cars. So there you go. Anyway, I guess that's all I got to really say. So yeah, John Peel really liked the song. I'm glad. I mean, he really helped the band, which is very cool of him to do. And again, they really deserved it. I mean, goddamn, the song was very good. The song was very energetic. Like I said, I love the drummer there. Love him smiley. Love the guitar hook. Love the guitar solo. And it's just, you know, it's in your face, but also it's very, but with Feargal's voice, it's not as much as in your face as you would think. Because he has that voice where it's so different to me. But anyway, I guess that's all I got to really say. So anyway, thanks for the request. I mean, my goodness, this was very good. Thanks for, I guess, watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. I really appreciate all the support, of course. And I guess that's all I got to say. So I'll end this now. I never know how to end a video. But anyway, I'll talk to you guys again soon.